हेलो फ्रेंड्स एंड वेलकम टू टिकर टीवीज कमोडिटी मार्केट अपडेट विद जतिन त्रिवेदी। आई एम सीनियर रिसर्च एनालिस्ट विद एलकेपी सिक्योरिटीज़ फॉर कमोडिटीज़ एंड करेंसीज़। सो फॉर दिस वीक वी आर लुकिंग एट द गोल्ड एंड सिल्वर ऑन अ वेरी बिट मच ऑन अ म्यूटेड ट्रेड सेशंस दैट वी हैव सीन ऑन द मंडेज मार्केट एंड दैट इज़ ऑन 5th April। एंड नाउ यू नो द मार्केट्स आर लुकिंग क्वाइट यू नो रेंज बाउंड to a little bit of a positive trigger which can you know shape up due to the US stimulus package announcement on the infrastructure spending. So this any stimulus package announcement definitely you know favors the bullions as the spending increases of the government, and it will help the bullions market for surely. But the situation becomes a little bit tricky because the number of COVID you know numbers are really high globally. But at the same time, the vaccination drives are also on a very strong note. So this will keep the bullions market a little bit on the volatile side. But the undertone for this week looks a little bit on the positive side till the time the levels are intact. So now moving on to the levels part, where the gold market on the domestic front holds the levels of around 44,800 on the lower side. Till then, it looks like quite positive for, you know, this week on the gold bullions front. For especially the gold prices on the domestic front. On the international front, till the time gold prices are holding 1690, 1685 odd zones on the spot, till then it looks a little bit positive, and bar and dips market looks on the cards as of now. On the higher side, gold prices will face resistance at the levels of around 45,800 to 900 odd zones on the domestic market. And on the COMEX front, 1730, 1740 will act as a barrier of resistance on the spot prices. Now, on the silver front, the markets will be even more volatile compared to the gold prices. So, the range play for silver for this week is between the levels of around 63,500 on the lower side. Till the time it is not breached, one can look at buying opportunities near 64,500 to 64,000. And on the higher side, 66,500 to 66,800 will act as a very strong resistance point. So till the time it is in this range between of a couple of thousand points, one should be looking at trading the range market of silver. Now moving on to the next part, which is the base metal. See, overall base metals are looking a little bit positive, looking at the copper prices holding good amount of levels and supports. Recently we have seen, you know, less amount of weakness witnessed in the copper prices, and a very strong gap of opening after that the prices are also holding. So one should be looking at base metals as a buying opportunities overall, all the base metals, especially the copper and zinc prices look a little bit bullish compared to the other base metal. So speaking about copper levels, 675 to 678 will act as a very strong support zone for this week, and on the higher side 690 to 695 will act as a resistance point. One should be looking at buying or buying the copper prices on dips. The metal index is also positive on back of positive triggers from the copper and zinc prices. So till the time metal index is holding 13,600 odd zones, till then it is a buy and dip market for base metal prices. Look out for the levels of around 13,900 to 850 for buying purpose. Moving on to the last part, which is the energy spec. Crude and NG both look weak for this week again. Looking at the current market scenario, where the crude prices have been quite volatile, but for this week again they look a little bit on the weaker side. So sell on rise strategy should be maintained till the time crude prices are below 4600 on the MCX. And on the natural gas front, till the time natural gas prices are below 200 odd zones, one should be looking at, you know, selling it on rise again after a smart rally that we have witnessed last week on the natural gas front. But the levels are, you know, failing to cross the 200 mark. Till the time 200 is not crossed, briefly natural gas prices are facing resistance every time near 200 odd levels and taking support near the levels of 180. So this is about it from me guys for this week on the commodities market front. Hope to catch you all next week. Stay home, stay safe. Happy trading.